Hello everyone, my name is Anur Pota. So today we are going to discuss about for loops in C. So I'll share the screen. So we'll see what are the for loops in C. Okay, so we are going to discuss about how for loops are used in C++. So the contents that we are going to discuss in this video is introduction to for loop, syntax of for loop, how for loop works, as well as we'll study the flowchart and nested for loops. First we'll go for the syntax of a for loop. So the syntax of for loop is as given below. So how it starts here is for statement, closing bracket, initialization, condition, and after that increment or decrement operator, and within this flower braces you have to write the code that is to be executed. Okay, so this is the initialization, this condition, and increment or decrement. We'll see one by one what are this initialization, condition, and increment and decrement. So there are three parts, as I told: initialization, condition checking, increment or decrement, and condition checking. So first step, what happens is in initialization, some variable will be initialized, like int I equal to 0. After that, the for loop will then go to the condition. So first it checks the condition. So whether the variable is less than some value. Only if the condition is true, then the execution goes inside the for loop. Okay. So this code, once it executes, again it comes to the increment or decrement operator. So this operator is used to either increment or decrement the variable. Once it decrements or increments, again the condition is checked. This for loop will be executed until the condition becomes false. So when condition becomes false, this loop will come out of the, or this loop gets exited. Okay, this is about the syntax of the for loop and how for loop works. Okay, so we'll explain it with the help of a flowchart. Okay, so as you can see here, this is the flowchart of a for loop. So we are starting the program. So when you start the program, you are checking the condition. Okay, so what, as I told, first you have to check the condition. Only if the condition is true at first time, okay, it will go inside the for loop. So inside the for loop, whatever the statement is there, that will get executed. Okay, so once the statement gets executed, again it goes on checking the condition. Okay, so once it again checks the condition, now if the condition is true, again it comes back to the statement, as I told again. So this process goes on until the condition becomes false. So once this condition becomes false here, so if condition is true, it will come here. If it is false, okay, it will exit the loop. Okay, it will exit that loop. After exiting, it will go forward with the next statements. So this is about the for loop of the flowchart. So we'll review one of the questions based on the for loop. What it says, what does the following code print? So this is the code they have given. So here I have declared a variable I. Okay, I equal to 0, I less than 10, I equal to I plus 2. So this is the initialization condition. So how it works here is, so we have to answer what it will print. So first it will initialize to 10. Okay, now I is less than 10, so it will check the first time. So 0 is less than 10, so it will come here. Okay, so it will print 0. Okay, but again it will come here, but as you see here, there is a semicolon. So many of the students do the mistakes of putting a semicolon. So this statement will not be executed because there is a semicolon here. So semicolon should not be put after the for loop. So it will not print anything. It will get a compilation error. Okay, it will get a compilation error because a semicolon is placed after a for loop statement. So always remember that you should not put a for loop semicolon after the for loop. So if there was no for loop, it could have printed even numbers from 0 to 10, because each time the I variable is incrementing by 5. Okay. Now let's see about infinite loop. So in addition to for loop, there is an infinite loop. That is, if you don't initialize any variable, check condition and increment or decrement variable in for loop, it is known as infinite for loop. So in other words, if you place semicolons in two semicolons in for loop, it is known as infinite for loop. Okay, if there is no initialization condition, there is no check condition, or there is no increment. So if you place only two semicolons, it will become an infinite loop. Next we'll see what is nested for loop. Okay, so nested for loop, that is one for loop inside the another for loop. So the inner loop runs as many times as there is a limit of the condition of the external loop. So there are two loops here. Outer loop will represent the rows, inner loop will be represent columns. So how it will be represent here is, yes, you can see in the syntax of the nested for loop. So initialization, condition, increment or decrement operator. So inside this, this is nothing but the inner for loop. So this condition or this loop will be executed as long as this condition becomes true. When condition becomes false, again it will go out of the loop. So this nested loop will be continued until the condition of the outer loop becomes false. Okay. So today we have studied about the syntax of for loop and how for loop works, as well as using the flowchart as well as nested for loop. Thank you.